Hi, Eugene. I think you've been following what is happening in our beautiful country, Zimbabwe, whereby everybody, the whole world, and the whole people in Zimbabwe were waiting anxiously to hear about what would President Mugabe's speech be like this night. It's likely that I'm reliably informed that he had his first copy, which he refused to give to the generals when he went when he was about to go for the live broadcasting. You see, these guys are dealing with a lawyer, one who is so intelligent in dealing with the constitutional issues. We heard that he had to take his time to read that long resignation letter, which is not fit to be a resignation letter in my context, because it was long, and he was trying to buy time. He was telling the people, the generals, and the whole nation that they must put aside those political differences, and they must uphold the ethos of the party and the democratic tendencies of the party. Even said is he prepared to preside over the Electric Congress in few weeks' time, whereby they're going to choose who should lead the party. You see how adamant our president is. He's so defiant. He was in a relaxed mood, as if nothing has happened. But I understand Mugabe wants to make people angry, if especially the whole nation, so that there could be a bloodful coup, where you could even get assistance from the SADC or AU, saying, "Oh, these people are trying to remove me violently from my post." It's likely that he want to drag all those generals to such a level. To me, is adamant, but I'm optimistic that by tomorrow, like what the generals have said, that they will try by all the means to get his side of the story at 12 p.m. Or failure to do that, then it's likely that they will impeach him in the parliament. You see, this is the situation now. It's a catch-22 situation, whereby the army wants to be seen like doing a very good job. Yes, they've done it. Yes, the people must come in and finish this thing. Yes, it's likely that pressure is mounting on him, and everybody now is waiting for him to resign. Let's wait and see how these events will unfold.